God's anointed now generation, this is Brother Damien, and I just want to tell you that I miss you all so much. Gang warriors and gang girls, I miss you so much, and I hope you're keeping well during this lockdown. And I have to tell you that I really, as I said, I miss you so much, and I can't wait to see you all again. Stay strong in the Lord, keep on pushing through, stay in your word, stay prayed up, and we're gonna make it through this. Amen.
So what God telling you to do your work?
You know he's still telling me to take a break. You see how he paused it?
No, you paused it.
I didn't pause.
You paused it. You better do your schoolwork.
I didn't pause it. He just paused it.
I need you to stop putting stuff on God. God,
yeah,
didn't
my.
Pause it.
Yeah, my.
Get over there and do your work.
Mama.
Ramon.
You know, I don't want to do the work.
You better do that doggone work.
You know, I don't want to do the work. Because God is doing the work in me. How am I supposed to be doing work when he's working in me? I need the rest so he has a stable foundation to upgrade on. How, when I'm moving, how am I going to get upgrades? When a car is getting upgraded, it's in a garage and it's standing still. When a superhero is being upgraded, it's in a garage and it's standing still.
Hey, what's up, God's Anointed Now Generation? Welcome and tuning into our gang service this evening, amen. And this is what we're going to do. I want you to stand up. We're going to open up the service in a word of prayer. We're going to go into a time of awesome praise and worship. So stand up, shake yourself loose, and we're going to open it up, amen. Heavenly Father, we come before you. We thank you for what you're doing within the God's Anointed Now Generation. I pray that you'd be with every young person there at their homes, Father God. I pray that you would minister to them and that you would just continue to have your way through the service. We give you all the honor. We give you all the glory in Jesus' name, amen. Come and give it up for our God's Anointed Now Generation worship team. Hallelujah. Come on, are you guys ready to praise him this evening? Come on, God's Anointed Now Generation. I want you to stand up and we're going to praise him tonight. Come and put your hands together.
Prophetic, I can feel it in me. We lift up
presence in your room this evening. Come on, we came to worship the King of Kings tonight. Come on, He's the name above all names. He's high and lifted up. Come, we bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. And there is only one name. And there is only one name for power to save. Up your hands in your room this evening. Sing it out with us. And our God is champion. He reigns forevermore. Forevermore. We sing it again. Our God reigns. He's champion.
Jesus Christ.
Wasn't that an awesome time in praise and worship? Amen. But we're going to go straight into it. This is what I wanted to do. We're going to get ready to give. Amen. How many know that in this time we're in, we don't want to stop giving, because it's through your giving that God can do amazing things within this world. Amen. And if you open up your Bible to Matthew chapter 6, as I get there, amen. Matthew chapter 6, verse 21, the word of God says, "For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." How many know that God does not look at the amount you give, but he looks at how you give and the condition of your heart that you give? And we want to encourage you, young people, don't hold back on your giving. I know that in this time you're not able to go to certain, come to gang and give cash offering, but we also have ways of giving online. So I want to encourage us, let's continue to give to our gang club, for those that have committed to the 5 rand member, 10 rand member, 15 rand, 20 rand, 50 rand, whatever God has laid upon your heart, continue to give. You can give via debit orders, or you can give through our SnapScan app. Amen. And like I shared the last time, you can follow us on our tutorial on the website and you can see all that information. But we're gonna close this off, we're gonna bless this offering unto the Lord. Amen. Let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, I pray that you would be with every young person as they give. I pray that you would bless them in abundance. Even in this time, I pray that you would be their provider, because your word says that you own a cattle on a thousand hills. And Father God, you will take care of every need, everyone's needs. Father God, we give you all the honor and all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
To make a payment via online giving, you need to firstly contact your local bank to activate your bank card for online payments. Go to Victory Outreach Cape Town website, vocapetown.net, and choose the giving option. Scroll down and choose your giving option. If you are giving from South Africa, click the red PayFast tab on the left. Choose your giving type. Put in your amount, which will reflect in Rand. Enter your full name, email, and phone number. Click on the Give Now tab. Regardless of your card type, click on the first tab option, Credit and Check Card. Fill in your email address and bank card details and click Pay. You will receive an email notification showing that your payments has been made successfully. Thank you for continuing to partner with us through your giving, and may God continually bless you.
Good evening, God's Anointed Now Generation and all our viewers online. Praise the Lord. It's good to be with you guys tonight. And listen, I have a word that I want to share with you guys, and I believe God laid this word upon my heart. So I want to encourage you guys to listen up. Let's get focused. Let's get all of those distractions away from us, and let's focus on the word of God here tonight. Amen. And if you guys could kindly stand with me wherever you are, get your Bible. Amen. Because we are going to get into the word of God. Listen, I want to challenge you, grab your Bible and let's listen to the word of God. Amen. And if you do have your Bible, turn to the book of Luke 6, verse 46. Amen. And while you guys are turning there, I would love to go ahead and thank God for my salvation. Thank God for saving me. And also I want to thank God for the opportunity that I have to preach here. I want to thank the leadership of the gang team for giving me this opportunity, and also our pastoral team. Not forgetting our founders, Pastor Sunny and Sister Julia Gonzoni, that laid down their lives to the call of God. And as a result of the obedience, we are where we are here today. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. So if you guys are there, let's go ahead and read the word of God. In Luke 6, verse 46, the word of God says, "So why do you keep calling me Lord, Lord, when you don't do what I say? I will show you what it's like when someone comes to me, listens to my teaching, and then follows it. It is like a person building a house who digs deep and lays the foundation on solid rock. When the flood waters rise and break against that house, it stands firm because it is well built. But anyone who hears and doesn't obey is like a person who builds a house right on the ground without the foundation. When the flood sweep down against that house, it will collapse into a heap of ruins." Let's pray. Father, we come before you tonight, Lord, and we just want to thank you, God, Lord, that we can still, Lord, share your word. We can still preach the gospel through the medium of media, social media, God. I pray, Lord, that wherever your people are right now, God, Lord, that you would sow up, oh God, in their midst. I pray that this word will bless them, God, I pray that it will challenge them, that it will provoke them, God, that it will inspire them to become all that you've called us to be. God, I thank you. Remove me aside and use me as your vessel here tonight. In the name of Jesus, and we all together say, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Listen, so when we look at the word right now, amen, there's the word of God, and we look at a key word, and this word is the word foundation. Amen. And when we look at the definition, the meaning of the word foundation, it is a basis on which something is grounded. It is the lower support of a structure and also an institution supported by an endowment. Now, simply put, a foundation is the base for something. Now, we often hear about the structural foundations of buildings, but a good idea can also be a foundation of your life. What you build your life on, is it in a career? Is it based on a relationship? Also, we can also build our marriages on different foundations, relationships that we have. Amen. Or maybe for us that's in the ministry, it could also be the foundation of our ministry. Amen. So the base of whatever it is that we build our lives, our ministries, or our careers on. Amen. And according to the words of Jesus right here in Luke 6, we see that he says, as his followers, as believers, we must make sure that we build our lives on his teachings. Right? In other words, Jesus' teachings should be the foundation of our lives. We see that Jesus uses a parable and he compares our lives with that of a house. He says, in order for a house to last a long while, in order for a house to weather the storms of the different seasons that it will face, it has to be built on a solid foundation. In Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1, the word of God says, for everything there is a season, a time for every activity under heaven. Amen. And if we take a moment to think about this, a house has to endure different seasons. In fact, a house endures 4 different seasons a year. And this is the very same thing with our lives also. During our lifetime, there's a lot of seasons that we have to endure. Amen. And I want to go ahead and use an example to illustrate something or the point that I'm trying to bring across here tonight. Amen. I'm going to use the UTC campus as an example. Praise the Lord. And I can testify that the UTC has a strong foundation, because it was clearly seen one day while we at the UTC, amen, out of nowhere there came a lot of, the weather was bad, there was a lot of rain, there was a lot of wind blowing, it was just crazy. It was like a day like no normal day, amen. All of a sudden, out of the blue, out of nowhere, there was flooding coming through the back gate of the UTC. We didn't expect this, nobody saw it coming, but luckily for our sake, because the UTC, the building was built on a solid foundation, nothing really happened to the building because it was built on something strong. The winds came, the rain fell down, but it could not move the building because of its strong foundation. Amen. Now, if we go back to the portion of text that I read, and we listen to Jesus, and he says that we should listen to his teaching, and not only listen to it, but we should also do it, right? And then I asked this question as I was reading it. What exactly are the words that Jesus is referring to? What is the words that he's referring to? Now, of course, in the gospel, all of the gospel, it's full of the words of Jesus. Amen. But this is the question that came up to me, and God took me to the word of God that is found in Matthew 6, verse 33. And this is what answered my question. It reads like this. It says, seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and he will give you everything you need. So whether that is the food, whether it's clothes, whether it's a job, a car, a house, whatever it is that we need, God says if we seek him first above everything else, that he will make sure to take care of us. In other words, if we seek first the kingdom of God, that will be a foundation for our lives. That is what we build our lives upon. If we look at the word of God in Psalms 119 verse 9, it asks this question. It asks, how can a young person stay pure? And then it goes to answer. It says, by obeying your word. Right? If we look at Joshua 1 verse 8, God commands Joshua and he says, study this book of instruction continually, Meditate on it day and night so you will be sure to obey everything written in it. Only then will you prosper and succeed in all you do. Listen, if we take the book of instruction, the word of God, and we are careful to obey everything in it, in other words, we make this our foundation, only then, listen, this is God speaking, and we know that God is no man that he should lie. He doesn't go back on his word. Only then will we prosper and succeed in all that we do. Now you ask yourself a question, why is it so important for us to have a strong foundation? And it's simply put because every foundation eventually will go through a time of testing. There will be a testing of our foundation. We see this in James 1 verse 2. The word of God tells us that when troubles come our way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For we know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. Also in 1 Thessalonians 3 verse 3, the word of God says, But you know that we are destined for such troubles. So listen, this is not something new for us. When our foundations are being tested, when troubles comes our way in life, this for us as believers is not something that we are not used to, because God tells us this is things that we are destined for. This is things that as believers we go through, we see it as an opportunity for joy because we know that this is how we grow. This is how God grows us. This is how he brings us closer to him. Amen. And there's no doubt that eventually our foundation will be tested every now and then. And I believe in this time that we are right now, this is a time of testing. For a lot of people, this is a time of testing. Whether you are a believer or whether you are an atheist, this is a time of testing. This is a time where our foundation is being tested. Amen. What have we been building our lives upon all these years? All of a sudden, there's a virus that broke out of nowhere. Nobody saw it coming. Amen. And we've been building our lives. We've been building our ministry. We've been doing different things. We've laid foundations. Amen. But this test that is coming is testing that very foundation that we've built. Whatever it is that we've been busy building on, it's testing that foundation during this time. Amen. And we know that as believers, like I said, Jesus says we need to build our lives upon him. We need to follow him. We need to make sure that we live according to how he teaches us to live. Amen. He commands us to live a certain way as believers. So we don't build our lives based on the likes. Come on, somebody. Our foundation is not the Facebook account that we have and the amount of likes that we have. It's not what people say about us. Come on, our foundation is not different artists that are out there, the music that we listen to. Come on, somebody, because how many of us know when your faith gets tested or if your life is built on things like that, eventually when your foundation gets tested, it will crumble because it's built on something that is not solid, right? Yes, we have a career that's important. Yes, education is important. Yes, all of these different things are important in this life and in this world that we're living in right now, but that is not the foundation of our lives that will be able to stand during the test of our foundation. Because even during this time, we see that a lot of people are losing their jobs. There's no security. Nobody is safe during this time of this pandemic. Nobody's safe. And there's people that their lives were like, everything was all about their job. It was all about their career. It was all about their education. And for some of us, it was about ministry. For some of us, it was about God. It was about church. It was about souls. That is what we built our lives upon. But now, during this test, I wonder what our foundation was built upon. Was it just built upon the works of ministry? Or was it built upon the words of Jesus? Was it built upon our intimacy with God? Amen. And we know that when something is tested, eventually there will be a result to the test. Amen. We know that when you go through trials, whether it be for sports, whether you're testing something in a lab or whatever the case may be, there is a certain result that we expect, amen. And I want to go back to my story that I said in the beginning, the example that I used with the UTC building, amen. The UTC building was able to stand the test of time because of the foundation that it was built on. It was very strong, amen. And listen, maybe during this time, our faith has been tested. Maybe we've been building on a foundation that right now you see that there's no security in the job that you were building your life upon, right? Maybe the relationship, amen, is being tested and you see there's no security in there. There's no strong foundation because you've been building on something that is not able to weather the storms of life. Maybe it's when it comes to your education, your career, whatever it is. Maybe it's your job. Maybe you lost your job. Amen. I want to encourage you. Listen, God still loves you and he wants to give you a second chance. Listen, you can rebuild your foundation upon the words of Jesus Christ. Amen. And let me go to the third point, which is the result of the test of our foundation. We see in the story, there's only one of two outcomes that can happen. Either the house will be able to stand, either we will be able to stand during this time of testing, or we will collapse into a heap of ruins, or we will begin to worry, or we will begin to fear, or we will begin to doubt in God. It's either the one or the other. And listen, we see if your house is not built on a solid foundation, eventually, when a flood like this comes, when a pandemic like this comes, it is thrown in a heap of ruins, right? But listen, there is also us as believers. Listen, I want to encourage you. This is our time. Our foundation is built upon the words of Jesus. We are not moved just because this pandemic is here. We know that these trials that is sent our way, these are things that builds our faith. These are things that gets us closer to God. These are things that for us as believers, these things makes us grow. We get better with this. Amen. So I want to encourage you. Maybe you are a believer and listen, your foundation has been built on God and you feel fearful. You feel like you're doubting. You feel like, man, what if this thing happens to you or your family? I want to encourage you. Get into the Word of God. This is a perfect time for us to get into the Word of God, get into prayer, because that is where we will begin to find encouragement. That is where God will begin to remind us of His promises, that He will never leave us, nor will He forsake us, that He is with us in the mountaintops and down in the valleys. God is with us. So I want to encourage you, if you are a believer, your faith is being tested right now, your foundation is being shaken. Hello, somebody. If you know that your trust is in Jesus, listen, Jesus is able to carry you through the storm. Jesus is able to bring you out stronger on the other side. Amen. And if you're somebody that maybe you did build on something that wasn't that strong, that wasn't that solid, God is a God of second chances. And God would allow you to build your life upon Him again. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. And listen, when we look at the result, when we look at the result of the test of our foundation, like I said, let me go back to the story of the building of the UTC. What one thing that I did notice is the building was able to stand during the time of testing. It was able to stand and weather the storm that hit it on that particular day. The storm didn't move the build like the building. It stood still, dead weight. Nothing happened to it because the foundation was strong. But then, after the storm was gone, or during the storm, all of a sudden we noticed that the drains of the property was blocked. All of a sudden we realized that there is a hole in the roof that we were not aware of. All of a sudden, we begin to realize that the lights was faulty, right? And just as the storm revealed different things in the building that needed attention, the storms of life that comes our way, the testing of our foundation, right, for believers, right? Sometimes we are not moved. Sometimes our foundation doesn't collapse. But what it does do to us, just like it did to this building, it shows us the areas in our lives in which we lack. Right? So listen, maybe this storm, this pandemic has revealed to you how little you've been spending time with God. Maybe this storm has revealed to you how little time you have spent in His Word. How little time you've spent to worship Him. Right? That is what some of the storms that comes our way are intended to do to show us, listen, you still need to work on this part of your character. Right? You still need to depend on God. You're still leaning on your own understanding. Hello, somebody. Come on. So we see that the storms of life for us as believers is not always going to cause us to collapse. It's not always going to cause us, you know, to fall, you know, and just like fear and do our own thing. But the storms of life will reveal to us the character flaws that we have in our lives. It will reveal to us the things that we need to work on to get better for God. Amen. Like I said, these the troubles that come our way is an opportunity for joy. For we know that the testing of our faith gives our endurance a chance to grow. So listen, I know that we are at our houses right now, and we have a lot of time. But I know also that God has been showing us, He's been dealing with us. Maybe when this pandemic came out, we were fearful. We were doubting. We're thinking, man, am I going to live? Am I going to die? Is God going to carry me through this? I want to let you know that He's going to carry you through this. I want to let you know that He's there. He will never leave you, nor will He forsake you, because your lives has been built on Him and His teachings as a foundation. Amen. And listen, I want to encourage those that do not have Jesus as your foundation. You do not have Him as your Lord and Savior. I want to encourage you. Give Jesus a chance. Jesus is able to take you through the storm. Jesus will keep you safe. Jesus will be with you. Amen. And He will continue to guide you in life. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And listen, right where you're at, I want to ask you to stand right now. Yes, stand with me right where you're at. Move whatever is in your way. Stand with me right now. And I'm going to go ahead and pray. I want to pray for you right now. And listen, I want to ask you to lift up your hands right where you're at as I pray with you. Hallelujah. Let's close our eyes. Father, I come before you tonight, Lord, and I lift up your people before you, God. Lord, you know, my God, Lord, what they built their lives upon. You know where it was on your word. You know where it was on a career. God, you know what it is that we built our foundations upon, oh God. You know what happened, oh God, Lord, when this storm hit us. You know our hearts. You know how we feel. And I pray for the one, God, Lord, that put their trust in a job and they found out there's no security. I pray for them right now, God, Lord, that you will comfort them. I pray, Father God, Lord, that you will touch them. I pray that you will move them, God, Lord, that you will bring them into a relationship with you where they are able to build their lives on a solid rock in the name of Jesus. God, I pray for believers right now, Lord, that during this time, this pandemic has revealed a lot of things in them, oh God, Lord, a lot of flaws maybe, God, Lord, a lot of things that they need to work on. Maybe it's they need to work on their relationship with you, maybe with family, whatever it is that the storm revealed to us. I pray that we will take heed and that we will continue to obey you by following your word. God, I thank you right now. I love you, God, Lord, and I pray that you would continue to be with us during this time. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you guys.